following last time. Today we will look at how the main menu disappears smoothly. After making sure the main menu is selected, we will create a new animation clip in the Animation tab. I'm going to name this clip Fadeout. Let's add the alpha property in the canvas group exactly the way we applied it to the fade in animation. Let's set the length of the animation to 0.2 seconds. Let's change the alpha value at the end of the animation to 0. This way, you can create a show that fades away over time. Be sure to uncheck the loop time option of the animation. Go back to the Animator tab and you will see the fade-out animation state is included. However, no method has been applied to play that animation. In order for the fade-out animation to play, the fade-in animation must have finished playing. Select the fade-in animation state, and right-click to reveal the options. Selecting Make Transition lets you specify which animation will play next after the previous animation has finished playing. If you complete this way, the fade-out animation will play automatically, so you need to create conditions for the next animation to play. To create a condition, try pressing the plus button in the parameter tab. In today's example, we will use trigger. Trigger condition is easy to think of as behaving like buttons. It will be executed when fade out, so let's name it accordingly. Now the condition has been created, we will add it to the condition of the animation transition. Now, let's make this parameter run through a script. In order to control animation in the script, the component must be imported into a variable. In the start method, we will write code to bring the component into the animator variable we just created. I'm going to comment out the setActiveFalse statement as we need to run the fade-out animation when closing the main menu. Now, let's execute the trigger condition we just added to make the fade-out animation play. Now let's run the game and see how it works. We see the fade-in and fade-out animations work as intended. However, when I try to re-enable the main menu, nothing happens. The reason is there is no processing after the fade-out animation is finished. Besides, you can see the main menu is also active, which has to be deactivated. After manually deactivating, let's reactivate the main menu. You will see that it works again. Then, after fade out is complete, we know we need to make the UI inactive. Let's go back to the animation tab and select the fade out animation clip. Add an event to the end of the animation. Animation event is a function that helps you to execute specific commands while animation is playing. Let's create a script to execute animation event. Create a public method and create code that disables itself and you're done. to run animation event, you need to put a script in the game object with the animator component. Select animation event and connect the method just created in the function option. When there are too many items, type the first letter U of the method name to make it easier to search. Now let's play the game again and see if it works. It is confirmed the main menu has been successfully disabled. It is also possible to turn the main menu on and off multiple times. That's all for today's video. Thank you, see you next time.